have that part, just kind of going over, finding the edges again of the object. And then, as you start to shade this, you'll see it builds up. And again, you can use the straight edge to help you shade it just because it's going with the form. It's kind of a quick way to do it. You don't have to, but it does get you set up pretty quickly onto this. And if this goes over the edge, it's not going to matter too much. But with the dark value, here's that band that's kind of in green. So I'm just going to shade this as if it has the highlight. And building this part up. Okay, so for the most part, that's the initial selection. And finding that edge there. So you have that. Anything that kind of has this reflective surface, it still has a tone to it. And you think of it even like a gradient if you combine it with the computer. Finding the edges for this section kind of has a reflective bend, and it only, since it's shiny metal, it kind of shows the edge, but then blends it off to the side there. So you kind of have that listed into that piece. Any darker segments, depending on the lead that you have, is going to give you that section. So I'm still kind of in a softer part of the sketchbook here, finding that edge again, and just continue to get some more lead onto that surface. The outside edge, since it is a dark line, it kind of skips a little bit and shows some of the values coming up. And the straight edge at least just helps you build that part up. Here's a little bit of a 4B lead. Putting that together. And it builds that section up. Now this does have a little bit of a cast shadow, so I'm going to do the same thing. Kind of just use the pencil to push against the straight edge. This is where it's going to fade apart, keeping that arch in there. Section. And if you want to get into it where it has a little harder surface to it, again, taking it so that it's off of that page, setting it right there, and now I have a harder edge to work off of. And it's kind of like in straight lines that it builds this value to it. And again, setting that part up there. So I kind of did this with the name tag, and now it's kind of carrying across. So I have that edge to it. Now I brought in a little bit, this is the stump that I was talking about, kind of has some charcoal on it, but it kind of helps smear the graphite, gives it a smooth tone that you can also use to pick out any kind of illustration for it, for shadows or highlights. And keep in mind, as it goes in the distance here, it'll get softer. And any of the type that's in this green band, I can just indicate, kind of like with the Greeking. And that builds that section up pretty good. So see how you put that on there. That section in there. And then, again, this has a little bit of a tone to it. So I'm just going to highlight it down there. You can smudge it a little bit. Take a little bit of the eraser. Okay. Go back in. Just touch up everything before you try the eraser. And here's the tool. So I'm just going to soften up some of the values. And if you take a look, the highlights in there, I'm going to go back in there a little bit, take an edge of the eraser, and just kind of smear it right through there. And that kind of brings out that section for it. And then once you find that highlight, you can go back in with the value. You can kind of see a darker shadow. And just pick that up a little bit. And if it took off too much, you can just go back in and touch it up here a little bit. So it kind of looks like, so you can really build up the edges.